Hello, this is Cristi. In this Descript lesson, we will look at how you can extract and export separate tracks from a Descript project if you have already made edits and you have a sequence with multi-tracks. Sometimes you may want to export those tracks individually from your composition using the edits you've made, keeping those edits, and then maybe assembling those files in another program for further mastering. Whatever the reason for this, I will show you in this video how you can export separate tracks, maybe two speakers, separately from Descript using this little trick. Let's have a look. I have a Descript project here with me and my friend Chris Menard. It's nothing happening here, we're just testing, but we recorded on separate tracks. So we recorded one video for him, one video for me, and also audio. So if you can see here, the entire conversation is in this composition here. And at the bottom, you see all of the different audios, one for me, one for him, different colors. So I made some edits, I made some cuts, and let's say I'm happy with the conversation. Maybe I will apply some audio effects from the sidebar here. If I click on the track there, select everything, and maybe I add audio effects. Let's say I add a compressor, maybe I will choose studio sound, whatever I do, this is it, the final version of my composition. Now, I may want to do this and put it in another program for editing. So for that reason, I may want to export the track separately. But Descript doesn't have a specific function for doing that. If you go to the top where the publish is, and you go to export audio or video, whatever, it just exports the entire thing, the final composition with both speakers. I would like to have separate tracks for that. So how do I do this? It involves going into the sequence for a minute. The way to do that is either double click down there on the track where the script is, double click, that will open the sequence editor for that portion. You can also get here by pressing Command Shift O like this, or Control Shift O on Windows, and you can also right click and say Edit Sequence. No matter how you get into it, this is your conversation here on multiple tracks. And in fact, if you resize this, which sometimes I can't do, you can see the both tracks in here. That's my track and that's Chris's track. But in the sequence itself, these tracks don't have the edits that I made in my composition. For that reason, I have to export them separately from here, from Descript. But before I do that, I have to mute all the other tracks and export them in turn. So the way to achieve that is, let's say that I want to export my side of the conversation first. So I go to my track, click on it here, and in the top right, you have solo track, like this. Solo track will mute Chris's track and only play my track. Let's click done, and let's see what happens. You see, my track is here with my speech, and you do not see Chris's audio playing. In fact, if I play, it's all going to be silent for his side of the conversation. So as you can see, Chris's track is now silent, and you can only hear my track playing if I go to a region where it shows my waveform. No sense, because if you have a bad connection. So with that done, with that track muted in the sequence, or soloed in that sense. If you have more tracks, by the way, it's helpful to do a solo on the track you want to export rather than the tracks you know going and muting each of the other tracks, right? So now that Chris's track is muted because mine is solo, I can go to the publish menu, go to export, and I'll just choose audio. I'm not going to export video. I'm just going to choose audio. And instead of current selection here, make sure you select current composition, and let's choose wave for the export and click export. This will export the entire composition and only my audio will be in it. But the nice thing is, and this is what I wanted, for the portions where Chris is speaking, they will be silent, but they will be kept in there so that there's going to be a period of silence every time Chris speaks. So we are keeping the synchronization correct. Yes, let's click export. Okay, the audio has finished exporting, and if I click open, it's going to take me to that folder where I can see now this file, Cristi Wave. Let's do the same for Chris's now, and we will actually go back in here into the project and I will press Command-Shift-O again to go into the sequence. And instead of now soloing my track, I'm going to go and take the solo off. You notice in the bottom there, the audio came back. And now I'm going to go and solo Chris's track now. So click on Chris's track and let's click solo. And if you scroll down there, if you look at the bottom, let's click done. If you look at the bottom now, the portions where Chris is speaking are now green and you can hear them again.
There's recording in a red font color.
And now if I go to portions where I'm speaking, I should be muted. Right, so now I'm ready to export Chris's side of the conversation as a separate file. Let's go back to publish again, go to export audio, and make sure it's not current selection, it's current composition again, because you need to export the entire episode or whatever it is, and wave and click export. I'm going to give this one the name Chris because that's his side, and let's click save. Descript is now exporting the entire composition again with my portions muted, and here we go, click open, and I have two files. Now let's see what I've got. I want to get these files and put them in another program. Let's say, for example, I want to put them in Adobe Audition or any other program, Audacity, whatever, to do some further editing or mastering on them. Let's see if the synchronization has been kept, right? So I'm going to launch Adobe Audition for a minute. And I will import these two files in Audition right there. And select both of them and say insert into multi-track. I just want to see if they have kept synchronization. New multi-track session. And here we go. Place each file on its own track. And done. Here we go. Both files have the same length. You see them right there. And both files have me talking, him talking, and so on. Let's play from here. Let's see if we can hear myself on this tracks number two. This is my first test of Riverside. And let's see if we can hear Chris down here.
Recording in a red font color.
So he's on a separate track. This is how you export different tracks on their own file from a Descript composition once you've made edits. So in Descript, of course, you can go and save your files from the media bin again, but these are the original files. They do not include any edits I may have made, any cuts, any sound adjustments, studio sound, whatever. So after you've done editing your episode, if you still need to maybe level some voices or something, you can actually use this process by selectively soloing each track and exporting it on its own. Descript doesn't have an automated way of achieving this, but you know, if you don't have a lot of tracks, this is not a very time-consuming process. Thank you for watching. I hope this was useful. If you enjoy these videos, please subscribe to my channel, like this video, share it. And if you have any other Descript questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. And I also have a Descript course. The link is in the description there. And I also provide one-on-one Descript coaching and training. So if you're starting with Descript, make sure you check those out and I would be happy to help and work with you. Thank you so much and I will see you on the next one.